Godzilla vs. Kong delivered it all in the simplest and most satisfying kind of way. The film in itself was a masterpiece, especially if we consider the choreography that went behind that epic Clash of the Titans, or should I say, Alpha Titans. Having said that, the film itself is far from perfect, but there's no denying that despite all the little imperfections, it's still a mouth-watering cinematic masterpiece of destruction and mayhem. The MonsterVerse finally brought the rabbit out of the hat in the form of the menacing, mechanical demon of chaos and extermination, Mechagodzilla. Oh, holy mother of dragons, the Mecha-G is absolutely crazy. Just one look at this monster and you can tell the sheer amount of havoc that the beast is capable of unleashing. But then again, did Mechagodzilla really deliver? Well, that's what we're here to answer today. So welcome back to Factaholic, and let's get right into it. So where do I even start? The Mecha God of Destruction is simply insane on so many levels. Starting right from its massive size, which is easily larger than both Godzilla and Kong, standing somewhere around 450 to 460 feet as per our estimates. Yeah, you heard that right. The height figure easily blasts past most of our modern-day monsters and titans. And it wasn't just the size department where the Mecha Titan dominated. After all, even when it came down to pure raw power and destructive abilities, Mechagodzilla seemed to have an upper hand over both the Alphas. Well, to be really honest, the Mecha-G overpowered the Big Monkey and Papa Goji in almost every department. For starters, that red mouth beam was easily more powerful than the much-improved atomic breath of Godzilla. We got a first taste of that in the Epic's headquarters in Hong Kong, where the beam was used to kill and split a Skullcrawler into two halves with relatively much ease, although that still seemed to be just a fraction of the Mecha's powers. The real showing actually came in when Godzilla took notice of the robotic nemesis and charged at it like a predator ready to pounce on its prey, only to find roles reversed afterwards. That's just how overpowered the mechanized kaiju was. Also, even after Kong finally decided to support Papa Goji and double-team the Mecha-G, it still seemed like Mechagodzilla dominated both. A destructive force unlike any other, Mecha-G seemed to be fueled by a shipload of steroids and testosterone, with testosterone levels seemingly higher than even the Terminator Arnold Schwarzenegger had in his glory days. Well, that's not exactly the case, but you probably get the idea of what I'm trying to say. Point is, the Titan was crazy powerful, and the battle was only getting better with the fight sequences, which was slowly building up pretty well, too. However, like all good things, there's some parts that are bad, too. You see, after the overpowered showing of the Mecha-G, MonsterVerse suddenly decided to end things abruptly, without any proper showing of the sheer potential destructive ability and power that this bad boy had in store. They just introduced the most powerful monster in the MonsterVerse who looks almost invincible. The next moment, they make him vulnerable with just a few pegs of alcohol simmering down the control panel of the Mecha. It doesn't seem quite right and clearly doesn't do justice to the reputation of Mechagodzilla. The MonsterVerse only scarcely displayed the true combat and destructive forces of the Titan. And guess what? We didn't even see the flying abilities that incarnations like Kiryu sported. Leave flying or any other abilities now, because only a handful of tricks were up for display. And honestly speaking, even though the film made it pretty clear that Mechagodzilla was overpowered, but in the end they didn't really make the Titan live up to its potential or reputation. Sadly enough, the Godzilla nemesis' outing was a rather short-lived one, who was absolutely decimated by Kong and his axe, along with the additional boost from Papa Goji. They were able to do this as the alcohol messed up with the control center of the Titan, and it wasn't a satisfying victory at all. We didn't really get to see much of Mechagodzilla in the first place, and when we did indeed get the little window of opportunity to see it in action, they made it go down pretty easily. That's just so not done. So again, going back to the question, did Mechagodzilla deliver? Well, our answer will be no. There's so much more that Mecha-G could do, and it's more than capable of what was actually shown. So those were the bad bits, and hopefully MonsterVerse makes up for it in the next outing, if there's going to be another film, that is. We'll definitely hope that there'll be more of the MonsterVerse and no more abrupt moments either. And with that, it's a wrap for this video. Of course, we hope you enjoyed it thoroughly. Thanks for watching. Now, if you want to keep watching more videos like these, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and smash that bell icon too while you're at it. We've got a whole bunch of other Godzilla vs. Kong videos you're probably going to want to check out if you haven't already. You've been watching Factolic. I'm your host, Scott Leffler. Signing off for now. Peace.